did you represent the City of Cumming or the County of Forsyth?
You all both had relations with the city, right?
Yes.
To me, it's a conflict of interest that you're even dealing with the city. The one has the best one, the other has the worst.
One thing, I've been sitting here for an hour and 31 minutes, like everybody else. And I think that you and Bobby Amos should recuse yourself in these negotiations.
Okay. Well, you're entitled to your opinion, and I'll just refer you to my voting record. Voting record is what it is.
People are wary of politicians that we don't know, and no matter what level.
Shows you the mayor's friendship.
Yeah, right. And you're in, you know, with your restaurant to that, that the mayor owns, and whatever, you know, you have, you can't say no to them. So, and like you mentioned, or Amos' family, they own, you know, Boo's the property in the county, so. It's understandable why you would be sticking up for folks in the city.
We have two public comment speakers signed up this evening. Our first speaker is Robert Bork.
My name is Bob Bork, and I live in District 2 of Powell Creek Way. And I'm speaking for myself, and I have no pending matter in front of the county. I want and deserve total transparency from my board commissioners. Given the information I obtained from an open records request from the City of Cumming, I'm going to ask the commissioner to recuse himself from all IGA discussions and votes until the end of his term for the following reasons. On April 1, 05, City of Cumming entered into a legal agreement for a retail lease with Schoolhouse Holdings LLC. Personally, I have almost 10 years of experience of executing literally hundreds of retail leases throughout the Southeast for a major retail corporation. I understand that what would be typical and atypical provisions in a retail lease. For my provisions, I have found that Schoolhouse Holdings retail lease that I have reviewed is not a typical retail lease. It is not typical that a retail lease that spans from April 2005 until March 2016 with renewals that receives no increases in rent over an 11-year period, that is not typical. It is not typical that no early lease termination fees are imposed in the agreement. With no early termination provision in this lease, it is not a typical lease. It is not typical that a lease contains no late penalty fees for paying your rent 5 or 10 days late within the month that the rent is due. According to the owned city's records, the leaseor has been late, past the 5 or 10 day grace period, in the past 15 of the 16 months, many times exceeding 4 to 6 weeks past due. It is not typical. It is not standard business practice to have all water, electric, and HVAC included in a retail lease cost. In this case, the retail lease cost from lease inception with renewals through 2016 is $2,500 a month, including all utilities. It is not a standard business practice in a retail lease to require only a $500 deposit to lease the place, but usually a month's rent. This is not a typical lease. It is not typical for a landlord or a leaseor to agree to conduct, and I quote exactly from the lease, promotion of the cafe where possible and appropriate in conjunction with theater activities for the tenant. This is not typical. It is not typical for a landlord to allow the open-ended use of additional rooms for catering activities at no additional cost without agreeing to the estimated usage rates in the lease agreement. It is not typical for a landlord to purchase and install awnings, flooring, window treatments, and new doors without specifically identifying tenant improvement dollars as on a per square foot allowance combined with an amortization schedule against future rent payments. This is not a typical lease. So I ask that the commissioner would agree that he can't be objective in any IGA discussions or votes and should recuse himself. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Our next speaker